He has risen. He is alive. This is Resurrection Sunday. Wow, praise God. And today with all the services, you're going to experience a great move of God all over the world. As the sun comes up this morning, it is the celebration of all Christians that believe in Jesus Christ. He is alive. Thank you, Lord. That means miracles are going to happen today. That means God's going to reach out when we ask Him to touch you, and you're going to be prayed for today. This is going to be a very, very special service for you. You're going to love the singing. You're going to love the worship. You're going to love the prayer, especially for you. You're going to love the message as I bring it. And you're going to enjoy as we begin to celebrate Passover. And I am so excited you are joining with us on this Easter Sunday morning. First of all, I want to tell you that I think it's come very, very quickly. We're already going just a few days into the fourth month of 2024. And it's hard to believe that Easter is here. Of course, it came early this year, but we're going to celebrate and we're going to have a good time with our Lord and celebrating His resurrection. So let's go into the service and let's celebrate Easter Sunday morning with you and the Lord and the congregation. It's going to be good.
with us this morning. I believe in the one salvation, one doorway that leads to life, one redemption, one confession. I believe in the name of Jesus Christ. I believe in the crucifixion. By His blood I have been set free. I believe in the resurrection. Hallelujah, His life is dead. All praise to God the Father, all praise to Christ the Son, all praise to the Holy Spirit. Our God has overcome. The King who was and is and evermore will be. In Jesus' mighty name I believe.
How could I ever walk away from the one who saved my life? all to purchase me. You are the Savior and the God who set me free. Now my heart cries, this is my Redeemer. With my whole life, I will give you praise. All the glory to the one who's worthy, because of Jesus, I have been saved. You made a way for me to enter into your holy place forever. Now I am hidden, I am covered, I found peace. Yes,
into your likeness you transform me, making me holy. You're holy, no other I who live, but Christ who lives in me. Now my heart cries, this is my Redeemer.
With my whole life,
I will give you praise.
All the glory
to the one
who
Resurrection Sunday, and we are celebrating, and we are so glad that so many people have come. You have come today, and we are delighted as more are coming. We are so thankful that there are people that know how to praise His holy name. And today we're going to pray for you. Pastor Mel is going to pray, and when she prays, get your faith. Take a hold of your faith. While she's praying, just start believing. When she's praying, go into agreement with your faith, because the Bible says when two agree, it shall be done. And God is going to touch every single one of you. How many want to be touched? Say a great big amen.
Amen.
Pastor Mel.
Let's just place our hand on our hearts together as we agree in prayer that every need will be met today. Father, we're so thankful that we could be here in your house. We're thankful for all the good things that you've done for us. We're thankful, Father, that we woke up this morning in the land of the free, in the home of the brave. We're thankful there's not war in our streets. We're thankful, Father, for your protection over our children. We thank you that you supply all of our needs according to your riches and glory. To those who may be feeling sick in their body, perhaps there's disease that's taken hold. Some with autoimmune diseases, heart conditions, cancer. Whatever it may be, we know there's nothing too small or too big for us to bring to you. You are our healer, and you took stripes on your back for that healing a long time ago. And we want to thank you for that. We want to thank you that we can approach the throne of grace with confidence, knowing that you won't withhold any good thing. We're thankful that to walk with you means that we're King's kids and there's more than enough. We thank you, Jesus, for all the blessings of this life. We ask you to restore those that need restoration in their lives.
Yes, God. Yes, Lord.
We ask you to deliver those who may have addictions and bondages upon their lives.
Yes.
To bring homes back together. Restore all that's been broken. We give you praise because we know it gives you joy to give good gifts to your children.
Amen.
And we're thankful that every good thing comes from our Father above. So we just want to thank you today. We know you have heard and answered our prayer, and the manifestation is on its way in Jesus' name. And everybody say amen. Amen. Let's worship him. Let's thank him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He is faithful. Yes, he's faithful. Hallelujah.
To where you could spread out and not worry about being in the gym, and you didn't have to worry about parking. Got close to the building, or almost close to the building. But we're glad that you are here today. We added this service especially for you, you that wanted to come today at 12:30, and the best is yet to come. Turn to somebody and say, he's alive, and you may be seated.
Welcome to our Resurrection Sunday weekend celebration. We are so thankful that you decided to join us today. If this is your first time here at Family Christian Center, we just want you to raise your hand. We want to see who you are. We want to see your beautiful faces. You all look good today. And if this is, if you brought someone and that individual doesn't want to raise their hand, they're a little shy, raise your hand for them. We're so thankful that you brought people to church. You brought your family to church. We're so thankful. Here at Family Christian Center, we reach the lost, we build the church, and we establish the kingdom. Our pastors are committed to lifting up the cross. They are committed to praying and believing for great things of God to happen upon your life. So we're so glad that you decided to discover Family Christian Center. So when you get that gift bag, just reach in, and I want you to pull out that Discover card. That Discover card, we want you to fill it out in its entirety. And then when the offering container passes you by, just place it right on in. Because as you are discovering who we are, we want to discover who you are. We want to get to know you a little bit better. We'll be connecting with you. And after service, we have another opportunity where you can connect to get to know more about Family Christian Center. Right outside on the west side of our building, there's a huge red carpet tent. We have prepared a guest reception just for you. Our team is out there ready to receive you. And we have another special gift that we want to get to you. So get out there. Get connected, greet and meet somebody, and we're so thankful that you decided to come to Family Christian Center. And now, watch this.
Happy to serve you. Once you get that, there's a couple things I want to talk about. Of course, your Passover envelope is in there. Just hang on to that for a little while. Pastor will be here in a few moments, and he'll tell you exactly what to do. I need some help in the front. Thank you so much, ushers. Doing a great, great job. Also, your tithe and offering. Now, your Passover offering does not take the place of your tithing. Passover does not open the windows of heaven on your life. It's the tithing that opens the windows of heaven, according to Malachi, that you cannot even contain it all. That is what is required by Jesus when we give our tithing. Separate blessings, very important blessings, blessings we don't want to live without, but also the Passover has its own blessings, equally important, but two separate offerings. And Pastor will speak more about those blessings in just a few moments. And as you prepare to give, our singers are coming to sing.
Thank you. took my place, laid aside my sin. You were buried for 3 days, but then you walked right out again. And now death has no sting, and life has no end. For I have been transformed.
Stretch your hand toward the seed. Those of you watching by streaming Facebook, YouTube, look at all the phones. Thank you so much for the phones. And on this Resurrection Sunday, I want you to know that you're going to receive a resurrection financial breakthrough. God is going to raise you up. Get ready because it's coming your way. We lift this up and call a blessing. The church said amen.
Day of the week, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb early, while it was still dark, and saw that the stone had been taken away from the tomb. Then she ran and came to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved.
They have taken away the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him.
Peter therefore went out and the other disciple and were going to the tomb. So they both ran together, and the other disciple outran Peter and came to the tomb first. And he, stooping down and looking in, saw the linen cloths lying there. Yet he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. And he saw the linen cloths lying there, and the handkerchief that had been around his head, not lying with the linen cloths, but folded together in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who came to the tomb first went in also, and he saw and believed.
like Monday. Help is my redeemer. Lift me up from the ground. Love is the power where my freedom song's found. There ain't no blame gonna hold my body down. There ain't no blame gonna hold my body down. When I hear the trumpet sound, there ain't no blame gonna hold my body
walked out of the grave, I'm walking free.
Freedom is mine.
If you walked out of the grave,
I'm walking to you. Jesus.
There ain't no grave.
Saved. The cross to them, this is foolishness that will be lost. For the Bible says that the preaching or the demonstration or the showing of the cross, it's foolishness to them that perish. But to us, it is the power of God. Anybody saved here today, this is the power of God. When we think about the cross, we think about what he did. This is a special day because we celebrate it because we are so excited that Jesus arose from the grave, and he did, and there's resurrection power even today. But it marks a time God created, as he said in Genesis, he created seasons That's the reason why there's the stars and the moon and the sun. And he created all of them so that we would understand what time it is when God operates. For instance, in Genesis, God specifically said these words, I made the moon, I made the sun, I made the stars. He says, I made them so that there might be seasons. And then he said these words, and they also might be signs. What does he mean by signs? When you begin to read in Zechariah and Chronicles, you begin to find out that God uses the sun and the moon and the stars, the comets, to speak to us. But the Bible says he speaks through the heavenlies. For instance, a week from tomorrow, an eclipse that has not happened in 1,000 years like this one. The last time this eclipse happened, the Mississippi rolled backwards. It was the greatest earthquake in the land. And God speaks to us and says, when the moon turns to blood, that's an eclipse. That's when the moon gets in front of the sun and we on the earth, we see the sun go black. That's the reason why the Bible says several times, as the sun turns black and the moon turns to blood. These are signs. Next week, I will be telling everybody to prepare for a week from Monday. You will hear this week, schools canceling, flights canceling. You'll hear jobs and people. You say, I haven't heard anything. Oh, you'll hear about it this week because this eclipse is going to happen on April 8th. And next week, I will tell you biblically and show you in the Word of God what this means. And just to give you a little preview, this eclipse goes over 9 cities in America called Nineveh. Nineveh. Let me give you another preview. The constellation in the heavens when this eclipse happens to be a whale. God speaks through signs of the zodiac and the heavenlies. You'll have to come and find out, because 7 years ago, God did another eclipse, and this one is the same eclipse, only it's going the other way. It puts an X upon the United States of America. And a lot of interesting things, because the X is exactly where Little Egypt is in Illinois. This is not just a circumstance. God is speaking. Do we have 40 days left? That's what he said to Nineveh. There's only 40 days left when he sent Jonah there. All of these are signs, and God has put them in perspective and is teaching us. That's the reason why the Bible said the men of Issachar are men of understanding or men of study. I was thinking this morning, how many sermons have I preached in 50 years? And I was figuring up the average time of preaching per week, which amounts to about 4 times. Usually a minister only speaks maybe 50 times a year in the pulpit on Sunday. And maybe he will speak Wednesday night, but usually if he gets in 50 to 60 or 70 messages a year, that's the average. So I would do 4, maybe 5 times a week. You add all of those up, that's over 15,000 times of reading the word and praying and speaking through these vocal cords, studying and observing, asking God, Lord, let me understand the times. And the Bible said that men of Issachar had understanding of the times. Aren't you glad you go to a church that has understanding of the times? It's important. Don't go to church for pretty sermons. Don't go to church to be entertained. Go to church to understand the Word of God. That is important. And so today is a sign. It's a sign. What is today? Today is a sign. It's Passover. Now we're celebrating it today, and because it's leap year, we Christians all over the world are celebrating it today, even though Passover is actually just a few days in the next month, the Jewish Passover. But today we're celebrating Passover and God honors that. What happens when we celebrate Passover? Well, Passover started thousands of years ago. You see this book or this Bible, it has two sections, an old and a new. And the old is 4,000 years old and the new is 2,000 years. And so the old Passover was way back there. Passover started when the people came out of Egypt after 490 years and God's people were slaves and God delivered them out on the night of Passover. And did you know that God has never deviated from the day and the time in the lunar calendar of Passover? So that Passover, he said, every year celebrate it by giving a year lamb. You will notice in the Bible that God did incredible things. And in the book of Exodus, he tells you, if you come before me on Passover like today, and you come and you present to me an offering. In fact, it was God's idea. This is not the Pope's idea. This is not some denominational idea. This is not a Steve Munsey idea. This is a God idea. And God said, I want you to come exactly on the day of Passover and I want you to offer me an offering. Now, why would God every year tell us to do that? Even in the New Testament, he told us to do it and that we would observe the times, because today, everybody, starts a new season in the next 12 months of your life. 6 months from now, we'll have atonement and it'll only get better. You'll have double portion. You'll have double portion in the next last 6 months. But today, oh, hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I'm ready for a new season, a new opportunity. I'm talking to somebody. This is your last day to walk through the valley. This is your last time to suffer the consequences. This, you got to understand what is happening. When you read the Bible, and the Bible says the pool of Siloam, for you that read the Bible says the water would be troubled and the people would gather. They knew when the waters would be touched. They were touched by an angel on the day of Passover, which is why they would all look and all wait, and the first one into the pool would be healed because the angel would touch them. So God said these words. God said, I'm going to send an angel when you give me the Passover offering. And I'm gonna do 7 things. It's all recorded there. God says, I'm gonna send that angel, I'm gonna send him to your house, I'm gonna send him to you, and that angel is gonna take care of your enemies. Oh, wow. That means whatever you've been going through, whatever the enemy's tried to put on you, God's getting ready to correct that thing with your angel. You read that, this is very scriptural. This is not anything hard to understand, other than if you read the word of God, God will be an enemy to your enemies. Number three, God will send you prosperity. Now, let me just tell you, you don't have to do this. This is not a heaven or hell issue. Well, if I don't do it, do I go to hell? Do I miss heaven? No, you can go to heaven broke. You can go to heaven not being blessed and still be saved, because you do not operate in the economy of God. See, God made an economy in this world so his people would be blessed. There's no money in heaven. There's no doctors in heaven. There's no hospitals in heaven. God created an economy for you to be blessed right here while you live. If you're waiting on the government to bless you, you're gonna be waiting a long time. In fact, we are $29 trillion in debt. And so if you're waiting on somebody to give you a handout, that's not going to happen. But guess what? God says, I will give you power to get wealth. I will give you prosperity. So he creates this season like a farmer that understands when to plant and when to harvest. God also says at Passover, bring me an offering. Now, I know when I read that, I say, now, God, wonder if people say these words, I don't have an offering. And God says, oh, that's a lie. because I gave them something. They may have spent it on something else, but I gave them the opportunity, because the Bible said, do not stand empty-handed. Then you find out that God does some other things. It's recorded when you give the Passover offering. He says he will take sickness away from you and your family. And if you read the scriptures, the Bible said in the midst of you, when you give the Passover offering, if sickness comes into your house, God will heal it. In fact, one scripture says that there is healing in the angel's wings. Here is another promise. God will give you long life. God, in fact, giving the Passover offering, God possibly will change your date of the day you're supposed to die, and you will live longer. Do you remember the story in the Old Testament where Hezekiah was 33 years old and his pastor came and said, you're going to die in 3 days? And then Hezekiah reminded God, I gave my Passover offering. And did you know in a few minutes God changed his mind? And the Bible says that he let Hezekiah live another 15 years because of the Passover offering. Did you know that when Joshua stopped the people and said, we need to give the Passover offering, and it was exactly on the day of resurrection, or what we call Easter, and he stopped the people and he said, before we can go any further, we need to give the Passover offering. And you read, they gave it, and the Bible said the next morning there was this creature in the middle of the road, and Joshua said, who are you? And he said, I'm an angel from heaven. And I'm going to lead you to the promised land. Anybody ready for the angel to lead you to your dreams? Lead you to the promised land. You could read many, many accounts of the Passover. You remember when Abraham was, God says, instructed him, said, put your son on the altar. And the Bible says that he was going to kill Isaac. Did you know that was on Passover? And did you know that when he raised the knife because he was offering his son as a Passover, did you know that the angel stopped him and an angel provided a substitute and a ram was caught in the thicket? You remember reading about Peter in the New Testament, you know, one of his disciples, who was arrested by the guards of Herod, and Herod said, I'm going to kill you. But Herod then said, I can't kill you, it's Passover, but after Passover, I'm going to kill you. Do you remember reading what happens? At Passover, an angel was sent, and there were 16 guards that were trying to watch Peter. But in the midst of that, the angel delivered Peter, and Peter escaped because an angel got him out of that situation. Anybody want an angel to help you in the time of need? Do you remember Jesus? Remember when Jesus was going to almost abort dying for us, taking our place so that we could have eternal life? You remember that? Remember that when he was in the garden, he started sweating drops of not sweat, but blood? He started panicking and he started to say things like this, I don't want to die. He's praying to his father. And he said, I don't want this cup. I don't want nails in my hands, crown of thorns. I want to back out of this situation. Do you remember what happened? The minute that Jesus said, let thy will be done, an angel appeared to him. And the angel gave him strength. And the angel showed him his future. Today, ladies and gentlemen, everyone that honors God with the Passover offering, there's an angel. If you do this, if you obey God, there's an angel going to meet you in your car when you walk out to it. It's an angel going to be at your house this day. And there's going to be orders, and there's going to be prosperity, and there's going to be blessings. And regardless of what happens with the eclipse a week from Monday, you're going to be in good shape because the angel of the Lord is going to be with you. You say, well, I've never heard anything like this. I didn't know. Well, just because you did not hear doesn't mean it's not true. This has been a powerful thing for us to do. And at the culture here, the Lord has said, tell the people to stand before me. And when we stand before him, we give him our Passover offering. Why, Pastor? Why would you do that? Because in Exodus, it said, do it forever. So I looked up forever in the Hebrew, in the Greek. I've looked it up in every language. And guess what it means? Forever. And people who say, I'm not interested in, it's under the law, etc. No, no, let me just tell you, when you're obedient to God, God will bless you. I could tell you numbers and numbers. I don't need to go on the testimony, but I could tell you numbers and numbers and numbers of people in this congregation that did not have anything. And today, it would amaze you with the wealth and the prosperity that is upon the people to be a testimony to all of the world. And let me tell you today, this is not a begging contest. If you think that I'm begging for the Passover offering, no, you're mistaken. I'm only telling you the good things, because if you're waiting for someone to beg you to do it, you need to keep it and go buy a hamburger and hope it tastes good, because the fact is God loves a cheerful giver, someone who says, I believe, I want the blessings of the Lord. I'll never forget when the governor called us and we was going through COVID and we were just about to start Jesus of Nazareth. And he said, don't do it. And it was the night before and we canceled it. And then everybody at that Passover, and by the way, I'll tell you Wednesday night of the four blood moons that are a part of this eclipse, that one of the blood moons happened during the Passover of COVID. And did you know that the whole world was shut down on the night of that Passover when we went through COVID? And that hasn't happened since the night that Israel was delivered out of Egypt. And when we began to go through that, I didn't know what to do. I didn't know whether to listen to the government. I didn't know what to do. So we took this cross. We put it out underneath the carport. I told as many people, drive by and we will serve you Holy Communion. You know how many, you know what happens when you take Holy Communion? The Bible teaches us that you will not die before your time, that you will be healed and you will have strength. Do you know how many cups of communion we passed out? People drove under the carport day and night, 68,000 communion cups. We fed 780 some thousand people with 17 trucks with 2,000 boxes of food that mysteriously showed up by some company telling me that we can give you 17 trucks with 2,000 boxes in each truck with a gallon of milk and chicken, etc. And we did that for almost 3 or 4 months, and I fed most of South Chicago and gave it to churches. We fed 780,000 people during COVID. You don't have to clap until you go hungry. That was a mysterious thing. I couldn't believe it. Out of nowhere, I get 17 trucks with 2,000 every single week. Did you know there's 22,000 people? Now, you all have it easy today. You're relaxed. Man, you don't have any. Boy, if you'd have been here in the other services, you'd have been crammed up in the gym. You would have. You all are taking it easy today. You're just sitting back. But in all the services, in fact, starting Wednesday night, baptized, did you see that? In one church, almost 200 people were water baptized. Holy Week. Oh, somebody say, thank you, Lord. And the average church in America, there's 435,000 churches. 435,000 churches. And did you know they don't even average one baptism a year? It was 200 Wednesday night. Not only that, there's 20,000 and counting this crowd and our Holy Week crowd and all of the walk to the cross and the Jesus of Nazareth. Did you know we will dip over into 20,000 people that have walked through those doors Holy Week right here on this campus with Jesus of Nazareth and prayer and all the things. Somebody say, thank you, Lord. Did you know they say there's 22,000 members that come to this church? And did you know during COVID, did you know it's a fact that only 4 people died with COVID? I stood in the gap. I refused for the devil to touch or to take our people. We fasted and we prayed and we put a cross out there. Don't tell me God can't do miracles. And out of the four, two came to us families and said, really, they didn't die with COVID, but because you get more money, I guess, when you are listed as a COVID victim from the government, that they died. And I know that many people died in many congregations, etc., but we stood in the gap because we took communion. But I'm going to tell you what I really believe it was. It was because we gave our Passover offering to God and our atonement offering. Miracles happened in this church that was unbelievable. Just last Friday night, we were celebrating the 50th gala of Jesus of Nazareth. And I had asked people to come from all over America to celebrate with me. And in my first Jesus of Nazareth today, 50 years ago, I was in Jackson, Mississippi. I was 19 years of age. And I built a set and trained the actors and made the costumes. And in Jackson, Mississippi, I did my first Jesus of Nazareth in the city in First Pentecostal Church. And we had to keep doing it week after week because so many hundreds and thousands of people came. And that was my first Jesus of Nazareth 50 years ago. And I wanted to celebrate that church. And the pastor had died, T.L. Kraft. He's gone to heaven. But his daughter was here. She was standing on the stage, and I wanted to honor her at our gala. She walked off the steps and had a heart attack. We rushed her out in the hallway, Winter and Dr. Sherman and Dr. Jamerson and Kim and some names I'm probably going to leave out, tried to resuscitate her. And as they resuscitated her, she came back to life for a moment, and it was good. And then that we lost her again, they said. Then the paramedics came, and when she was in the ambulance, the doctor told me personally, when I went to the emergency room, the doctor said there was 8 minutes that her heart had died, lost her. And when she got to the hospital, we began to pray, and the congregation began to pray. And I've got good news for you. I talked to her yesterday. She's alive and well in her heart. I'm glad I go to a church where there's the power of healing. Deliverance. Today she's in the hospital. She's getting better and better, and she's out of intensive care. And today we have the opportunity to say, Lord, here's my Passover offering. Now I make a big deal of this, and I'll tell you why. Every person in a moment will get to touch the cross, and we will do it row by row, and we do it so orderly. And the reason why I do that is because it's like offering our Passover. You bring your phones, you touch the cross. And every person that comes today, we are giving you a gift. This is the most incredible gift. And people have been telling me all morning long, this is unbelievable what the church has given me as a remembrance. And every person, now, if you have come as a guest and you say, I don't know anything about the Passover offering, that's fine. I still want you to come. Join the march to touch the cross, and let us give you this incredible, wonderful gift that you will remember Jesus by on this day. But I do it orderly because I think it's important to stand before the Lord and to say, Lord, here is my Passover offering. And so what's going to happen today is this section, you'll come from the back, the ushers will lead you, and you'll come down, and this section will make a circle, and this section you'll make a circle around, and orderly from the cascade, and for you in the balcony, special crosses are up there, that you will come from row by row. So all of you watch your ushers, start from the back, you start coming down here, and you'll touch the cross. And all of you over here, you will go that way to the aisle. All of you, you all will come to this aisle. And you'll make two lines coming down. And you over by the wall will come and go around these wonderful, precious people. And you will make the circle, you here. And your gift will be given. Most important thing, touch the cross. Because today, we are changing seasons. And God is going to dispatch his angels for all those that are obedient. So would you stand in the back, and as the ushers are directing you, start coming down the aisles, and we're going to worship as you touch the cross. Come, even our guests, come and touch the cross.
rejoice and be glad, rejoice and be glad in me. This is where I believe that you are more than enough for me. You are faithful to your promise, you are strong when I am weak. When I'm standing in your presence, I have everything I need. The joy of the Lord, the joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord, the joy of the joy of the Lord is my strength.
This is a holy moment. This is a holy moment. The reason why all the balcony and the floor, somebody help me. Music, please. This is a holy moment because we stand before the Lord to give Him our offering. So everyone say, oh Lord, we give our Passover offering unto you in the name of the Lord. Today, sometime when you depart from here, that angel, somehow God is going to prepare. You need to get ready for a new season. And just like we bury our seed, because when we give, it is like seed, and we put it into the ground and it brings a mighty harvest. And I am so excited because I want to put it in the tomb and I want to bury it so that you're going to get a mighty harvest. And I want to tell you today that in the tomb was something very special, which was a folded napkin about Jesus' head. And the Bible says that Jesus took it off of his head. And when he took it off of his head, he wrapped it up and he placed it in a place by itself. And that was significant because Jesus did that napkin that was on his head. And he put it in a place by itself. And the Bible says that Peter and John, when they saw that, they knew that he was coming back, because it meant in Jesus' day, if you enjoyed the meal of a house and you were eating and you wiped, you know, as you do a napkin, your face or your hands, if you folded it back and put it, if you put it in a place on the table away from your plate, it meant that everybody that was there, they saw that you said, I enjoyed everything, I'm inviting myself back. And when Peter and John saw that the folded napkin was in the tomb, they shouted and said, he's coming back. And I want to tell everybody, he's coming back. He's coming back. He's coming to do miracles in your life. And he's coming to do great things in your life. Everybody have a happy, happy Easter. Choir. So this is the choir, and they all sang today. We did four services, and we had lots of room in this service, but we thank you for tuning in. We thank God for all the people that came, and Holy Week was successful with over 20-some thousand people. Baptism 200, and you are the most important. You be blessed, and let the power of resurrection be in your life. We'll see you Wednesday night. God bless you.